Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. This is me, Muhammad Asif Zaid, and I am working as a lecturer at the Institute of Paramedical Sciences, Hyber Medical University. Dear viewers, today we are going to discuss another important topic of hematology, and the topic is acute leukemia. We have discussed in the previous lecture about leukemia and various types of leukemia. So in acute leukemia, we have already discussed that acute leukemia is that type of leukemia in which the sign and symptoms in a patient with acute leukemia is sudden, and in acute leukemia mostly there are immature cells like blast cells. And according to FAB classification, the concentration or percentage of blast in the bone marrow will be more than 30%, while according to WHO classification, the blast percentage in bone marrow will be more than 20%. So there is a variation between FAB classification and WHO classification. So today we are going to discuss about acute leukemia, and in acute leukemia we will discuss acute myeloid leukemia. We can see in this picture that there is maturation series of granulocytes. Like this one, this is myeloblast. Myeloblast then multiply into a promyelocyte. We also discuss about lymphoblast and myeloblast, that what is the difference between a lymphoblast and a myeloblast. So this is a promyelocyte. Promyelocyte is a large cell having primary granules and open chromatin pattern in the nucleus, and the nucleolus is usually present like this is a nucleolus. After promyelocyte, there is another stage, and this stage is known as myelocyte. The NC ratio of myelocyte is high, cytoplasm is 50%, while nucleus is also 50%. Nucleolus may be plus minus, like in this picture we can see that there is a clear nucleolus. And another important feature of myelocyte is that in myelocyte, instead of primary granules, secondary granules appear in this stage. As we know that secondary granules is also known as specific granules, because these granules specify that which type of cell it would be, like basophil, like eosinophil, like neutrophil. So if it is a neutrophilic myelocyte, then there will be red color granules. But if it is an eosinophilic myeloblast, so there will be orange color granules. While if it is a basophilic myeloblast, so there will be myelocyte, so there will be blue-black granules appear in this stage. After this stage, another stage appear, and that stage is known as metamyelocyte. Like in this picture, we can see that this is a metamyelocyte. What is the difference between a metamyelocyte and myelocyte is only that in nucleus there is an indentation, like the nucleus become kidney shape. We can see that in myelocyte the nucleus is completely round, while in metamyelocyte the nucleus is not round, rather it is a kidney shape nucleus. And after that, there this stage is known as band cell, in which further indentation of the nucleus occur and the nucleus become U-shaped. So this is the main difference between a band cell and a metamyelocyte. So this is basically maturation series of myeloid series, and especially granulocyte. Now acute myeloid leukemia, as the name indicates that this is acute, and the lineage of cell involved is myeloid cells, and it is leukemia, that is monoclonal proliferation of myeloid or lymphoid cells is known in the bone marrow, and if these immature cells spill into the peripheral circulation, that is known as leukemia. So acute leukemia is basically, acute myeloid leukemia is that type of leukemia in which myeloid cells are involved, and the signs and symptoms will be sudden, and there will be more than 30% blast present, myeloblast present in the bone marrow according to FAB classification, and according to WHO classification, more than 20% blast will be present in the bone marrow. So acute myeloid leukemia has an incidence of 2 to 3% per 1 lakh per annum in children, rising to 15% per 1 lakh in older adults. Acute myeloid leukemia, another important property is that acute myeloid leukemia usually occur in adults, while acute lymphoblastic leukemia usually occur in children. So that is the main difference between acute myeloid leukemia and acute lymphoid leukemia. Now, classification of acute myeloid leukemia. So we have already discussed that there are two type of classification, that is WHO classification, which is the latest one, and FAB classification, which is older one. But still in labs, usually FAB classification is usually followed rather than WHO classification. WHO classification is usually based on morphology, cytogenetics, molecular genetics, and immunological markers. Cytogenetics means genetic of the cells, while immunological markers mean CD markers, which we usually perform through bone flow of cytometry. And according to WHO classification, there will be 20% blasts present in the blood and bone marrow, but usually in bone marrow. But if more than 20% blasts is present in bone marrow, so it means that the blast concentration will also be increased in peripheral circulation. While FAB classification, which is an older one, is based upon morphology and cytochemical stains. And according to FAB classification, there will be more than 30% blasts in the blood and also in the bone marrow. So that is the main difference between WHO classification and FAB classification. FAB classification of acute myeloid leukemia. So acute myeloid leukemia is divided into 8 types of acute myeloid leukemia: M0, M1, M3, M4, M5, M6, and M7. Now another type is also added, and that is M8, which is acute basophilic leukemia. So what is the difference between M0, M1, M3, M4, M5, and M6 and M7? So M0 is minimally differentiated. M1, acute myeloid leukemia without maturation. M2, acute myeloblastic leukemia with maturation. M3, hypergranular promyelocytic leukemia, yeah, acute promyelocytic leukemia. While M4, acute myelomonocytic leukemia. M5, acute monocytic leukemia. M6, erythroleukemia. And M7, megakaryoblastic leukemia. So these are 8 types of acute myeloid leukemia based on FAB classification. Now we will discuss it further in details, like acute myeloblastic leukemia, which is minimally differentiated. It means that in this type of leukemia, blasts will be more than 30%, but without granules. In this leukemia, the blasts will be usually myeloblasts, but as there is minimally differentiated, means that we cannot differentiate it further, like either it is promyelocyte or myeloblast, but the blast concentration will be more than 30%, and we cannot differentiate it. So this is urd, this is cytochemical stains like MPO and Sudan black B, this is chloroacetate, and this is non-specific esterases. And these are chloroacetate, and this stain is also known as specific esterases. So in acute myeloblastic leukemia and minimally differentiated, there will be no urd present in myeloblast, while Sudan black B stain will be negative, and chloroacetate stain is also negative, and non-specific esterase test and stain is also negative. Positive myeloperoxidase or sudan leukemia means that more than 5% of the blasts will show sudan leukemia positivity or MPO positivity, and same case is with chloroacetate and non-specific esterases. Now in N1, which is acute myeloblastic leukemia without maturation. Without maturation ka matlab ye hai ki more than 30% myeloblasts will be present in the bone marrow, while less than 10% of the cell show maturation beyond blast stage, like we have discussed that they are promyelocyte, myelocyte, metamyelocyte, band cells, and then mature neutrophil or eosinophil or basophil. So in this type of leukemia, that is in M1, there will be less than 10% of the cells will be promyelocyte or myelocyte or metamyelocyte or band cells. So the percentage will be less than 10%. In this leukemia, ORR may be plus minus. ORR is basically a linear aggregation of primary granules. As there is less than 10% maturation, so in a myelocyte or promyelocyte or even myeloblast, there will be ORR present. So if primary granules is present, so myeloperoxidase enzyme is very, usually found in primary granules of myeloid series. So as primary granules are present, therefore sudan leukemia and MPO will be present. Sudan leukemia stain usually stain the phosphoproliferate of primary granules, that's why it is positive, and chloroacetate is also positive. Just remember that specific esterases are chloroacetate esterases is positive for granulocytic series, while non-specific esterases in this case is negative. After that, M2, that is acute myeloblastic leukemia with maturation. With maturation means that the percentage of mature cells will be more than 10%, while myeloblasts will be more than 30%. So in this leukemia, ORR will be positive, MPO and sudan leukemia is also positive, and specific esterases is plus minus, means it may be positive or it may be negative, and non-specific esterases is also negative in this case, because non-specific esterases are usually positive in monocytic series like monocyte or monoblast or promonocyte. And after that, M3, acute promyelocytic leukemia. In acute promyelocytic leukemia, there will be more than 30% myeloblast and promyelocyte with prominent granules. In this leukemia, promyelocyte is predominant, that's why it is known as acute promyelocytic leukemia. So in this leukemia, ORR will be much positive and present in higher concentration, and we will discuss it in next slides. MPO and sudan leukemia is also positive, chloroacetate is positive, and non-specific esterases is negative in acute promyelocytic leukemia. Acute promyelocytic leukemia is further divided into two, that is acute promyelocytic leukemia A, M3A, M3B. M3A is hypergranular, while M3B is hypogranular. After that, M4 acute myelomonocytic leukemia, as the name indicates, that in this type of leukemia there will be two lineage, that is myeloid lineage plus monocytic lineage. So myeloblast and monoblast and promyelocyte will be more than 30% in the bone marrow, monocytic series will be more than 20%, or ORR may be plus minus. Sudan leukemia is also positive, chloroacetate is also positive, while non-specific esterases is also positive, because in this leukemia there is monocytic series is also present, that's why non-specific esterases is also positive. In 5A, acute monoblastic leukemia without differentiation. In this leukemia, more than 80% of the monocytic series is present in the bone marrow, and more than 80% are large monoblasts with lethy nuclear chromatin and abundant cytoplasm. As the name indicated, this is without differentiation. Without differentiation means that most of the cell will be monoblast. So overall, Sudan leg B and non-specific stresses are negative in this case, while non-specific stresses are positive. While specific stresses is negative, because in this case most of the cells are monoblast. After that, M5B acute monoblastic leukemia with differentiations means that in this leukemia most of the cells will be monocyte. More than 80% monocytic cells with monoblast, promyelocyte and monocyte. Means that beyond monoblast there will be present promonocyte and monocyte in the bone marrow and also in the peripheral circulation. So in this case, outward may be plus minus, while Sudan leg B and chlorocytate is negative and non-specific stresses is positive. After that, M6 acute erythroleukemia, as the name indicates that there is erythroblast will be present in the bone marrow. So megaloblast erythroid precursor is more than 50% and myeloblast more than 30%. So ORRAD and Sudan leg B will be positive, while chlorocytate is negative, non-specific stresses may be plus minus. M7 is megakaryocytic leukemia, in which megakaryoblast will be present in the bone marrow. We will discuss morphology of megakaryoblast in the next slide. So ORRAD, Sudan leg B and MPO will be negative, while chlorocytate may be plus minus, and similarly non-specific stresses is also positive in this case. Now peripheral examination of acute myeloid leukemia. Most patients with acute myeloid leukemia present with anemia. Whenever the percentage of blast is increased in the bone marrow, so it will suppress erythroid series, that's why anemia will be present in these patients. Usually anemia is normocytic normochromic anemia, and there will be leukocytosis in peripheral circulation, and usually the count is more than 2 legs or 1 leg or 80,000, but mostly predominant cells will be myeloblast, and there will be also thrombocytopenia, because these blast cells will suppress megakaryocytic series, that's why thrombocytopenia will be present in these patients. Now this is acute myeloid leukemia M0. We can see in this picture that majority of the cells are myeloblast. In these myeloblasts are not differentiated, because most of the cells are blast cells and there is no mature cells present, that's why we call it minimally differentiated, that it cannot be differentiated into further mature into promyelocyte or myelocyte. Now this is M1, and M1 we say that this is without maturation, that is that promyelocyte will be present but in lesser concentration, like we say that there will be less than 10% mature series present. So we can say that this is a myeloblast, this is also a myeloblast, this is also a myeloblast, and this one is also a myeloblast, but this is, as there is prominent nucleolus present, so this is promyelocyte. So the promyelocyte or myelocyte, the percentage will be less than 10%, which is the property of M1. And M2, we called it acute myeloid leukemia with maturation. Like in this case, we can see that their maturation series will be more than 10%, and we can see that there is granules present in this cell. This cell also contain granules, this cell also contain granules, this is a myeloblast having no granules, this is also a myeloblast having no granules, and this is also a myeloblast having no granules. So more than 10% of the cells will contain maturation beyond the blast stage. This is acute promyelocytic leukemia, and this is a promyelocyte. In acute promyelocytic leukemia, there is a specific translocation present, and their translocation is known as translocation 15-17. Another property of acute promyelocytic leukemia is that majority of the cell will be promyelocyte, and there will be abundant or present in promyelocyte. So this cell is known as Fagot cell. Fagot cell is the type of cell in which there is abundant or rod present, and this is an or rod. This one is also a rod. So majority of the cells will contain or rod. So that cell is known as Fagot cell. Another property of promyelocyte is that in this leukemia, a DIC will occur. DIC means disseminated intravascular coagulation. And DIC occur because these granules contain procoagulant activity, which activate coagulation cascade. And whenever coagulation cascade is activated, thrombosis will occur. Platelet count will be decreased because when coagulation occur, platelet also aggregated, and it causes thrombocytopenia. Similarly, when coagulation cascade is activated, it will cause thrombosis, and this thrombosis will occur in various organs. So mostly in this leukemia, various organs will be damaged. So that's why this is known as DIC, means disseminated intravascular coagulation. Or DIC mein jo microcirculation hai, usme thrombosis ho jati hai. और थ्रोम्बोसिस की वजह से ऑर्गन फेलियर हो जाती है, इसलिए हम इसको कहते हैं वाइड स्प्रेड थ्रोम्बोसिस इन माइक्रो सर्कुलेशन, विच इज द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ डीआईसी. लेकिन वन ऑफ अनदर प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ प्रोमायलोसाइटिक ल्यूकेमिया इज दैट दिस इज अ गुड ल्यूकेमिया अमंग ऑल टाइप ऑफ ल्यूकेमिया, क्योंकि इसकी ट्रीटमेंट बहुत ही आसानी से हो जाती है बिकॉज ऑफ ट्रांसलोकेशन 15-17. This is acute myelomonocytic leukemia. ये सेल भी मोनोब्लास्ट हैं. ये मायनोसाइटिक सीरीज है और ये माइलॉइड सीरीज है, चूंकि और ये प्रोमायलोसाइटिक है. चूंकि इसमें मोनोब्लास्ट भी है, प्रोमायलोसाइट भी है और माइलोब्लास्ट भी है, इसलिए हम इसको कहते हैं एक्यूट माइलोमोनोसाइटिक ल्यूकेमिया. यानी दो लीनेज हैं, इसमें मोनोब्लास्ट भी हैं और माइलॉइड सीरीज भी हैं, इसलिए हम इसको कहते हैं एक्यूट माइलोमोनोसाइटिक ल्यूकेमिया. रिमेंबर कि एक्यूट माइलोमोनोसाइटिक ल्यूकेमिया दिस इज वन ऑफ द डेंजरस ल्यूकेमिया, क्योंकि मोनोसाइट जो है या मोनोसाइटिक सीरीज जो है ये सीनेस इन्वॉल्वमेंट इसमें हो जाती है, क्योंकि मोनोसाइट आर वेरी स्टिकी सेल्स एंड इट हैव द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ पेनेट्रेशन. सो देन इट पेनेट्रेट इनटू सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम एंड डैमेज इट. दैट्स व्हाई न्यूरोलॉजिकल प्रॉब्लम्स यूजुअली अकर इन M4 M5. देयरफॉर दिस ल्यूकेमिया आर डेंजरस ल्यूकेमियास. नाउ M5A व्हिच इज विदाउट डिफरेंशिएशन आर पुअरली डिफरेंशिएटेड, एंड वी कैन सी दैट all these cells are monoblast and promonocyte. Like this one is monoblast, this one is also monoblast, this one is also monoblast, this one is also monoblast, and this one is promonocyte. Monoblast usually large cells hote hain, and the cytoplasm is gray in color, and these are largest cells in bone marrow. To chunki isme sirf aur sirf monoblast hi hote hain, isliye hum isko kehte hain acute monoblastic leukemia and poorly differentiated. Now this is erythroid leukemia M6. M6 की property ये है कि peripheral circulation में भी erythroid series आ जाते हैं और highest concentration में होते हैं. अगर हम इसको देखें तो ये एक erythroid series है, erythrochromatophilic और polychromatophilic cells है. लेकिन और अगर हम देखें तो इसमें nuclear cytoplasm asynchronism भी मौजूद है. पेरिफेरल सर्कुलेशन में यूजुअली मायलोब्लास्ट नजर आते हैं, सॉरी एरिथ्राइड सीरीज नजर आते हैं बोन मैरो में, जबकि पेरिफेरल सर्कुलेशन में भी एरिथ्रोब्लास्ट नजर आते हैं, जैसे कि हमें ये नजर आ रहे हैं, दिस इज वन ऑफ द एरिथ्रोब्लास्ट। MC1 मेगाकेरियोब्लास्टिक ल्यूकेमिया, लाइक दिस इज वन ऑफ द मेगाकेरियोब्लास्ट एंड दिस इज आल्सो अ मेगाकेरियोब्लास्ट। इसकी प्रॉपर्टी ये है कि जो मेगाकेरियोब्लास्ट हैं, साइटोप्लाज्म में बडिंग इसमें नजर आती है, जैसे ये साइटोप्लाज्मिक बडिंग है, इसी तरह ये भी साइटोप्लाज्मिक बडिंग है, ये भी साइटोप्लाज्मिक बडिंग है। तो मेगाकेरियोब्लास्ट यूजुअली साइटोप्लाज्मिक बडिंग इसमें होती है, क्योंकि साइटोप्लाज्म से प्लेटलेट शेड होते हैं, इसलिए हम इसको कहते हैं कि चूंकि ये मॉर्फोलॉजी किसी और सेल की नहीं होती, तो चूंकि इसमें साइटोप्लाज्मिक बडिंग है और इसके साथ साथ जो न्यूक्लियस है उसकी मॉर्फोलॉजी भी डिस्टर्ब है। यूजुअली जो मेगाकेरियोब्लास्ट होते हैं ये फर्दर डिवाइड होते हैं, इनका न्यूक्लियस भी डिवाइड होता है, दो से चार, चार से आठ, आठ से 16 और 16 से 32, इसी तरह न्यूक्लियस इसके बनते हैं और फिर साइटोप्लाज्म से प्लेटलेट शेड होते हैं। लेकिन चूंकि इसकी कंसंट्रेशन बोन मेरो में बहुत ही ज़्यादा हो जाती है मेगाकेरियोब्लास्ट की, तो मोर देन 30%, इसलिए हम इसको कहते हैं एक्यूट मेगाकेरियोब्लास्टिक ल्यूकेमिया। एक और प्रॉपर्टी एक्यूट मेगाकेरियोब्लास्टिक ल्यूकेमिया की ये है कि एक्यूट मेगाकेरियोब्लास्टिक ल्यूकेमिया में बोन मेरो में फाइब्रोसिस होती है, क्योंकि मेगाकेरियोब्लास्ट में ग्रेन्यूल्स होते हैं जिनको हम कहते हैं अल्फा ग्रेन्यूल्स, एंड अल्फा ग्रेन्यूल्स कंटेन अ ग्रोथ फैक्टर व्हिच इज नोन एज प्लेटलेट डिराइव्ड ग्रोथ फैक्टर, और प्लेटलेट डिराइव्ड ग्रोथ फैक्टर कोलेजन फाइबर्स को एक्टिवेट करते हैं फाइब्रोब्लास्ट को, जो कि फिर फाइबर्स बनाते हैं और वो बोन मैरो को फाइब्रोस कर देती हैं। तो ये MC1 की एक प्रॉपर्टी है। नाउ बोन मैरो एग्जामिनेशन इन एक्यूट माइलॉइड ल्यूकेमिया, सो बोन मैरो एस्पिरेशन शो हाइपरसेलुलरिटी, प्रीडोमिनेंट सेल्स विल बी माइलोब्लास्ट, एरिथ्रोपोसिस विल बी सप्रेस, also plasma cell will be present in highest concentration as compared to normal and megakaryocyte will be reduced, but if it is in case of MC1 so the megakaryoblast will be increased. This is a clinical feature of acute myeloid leukemia. We have also discussed in last table, like this is step subtype, this is MPU and Sudan black B, this is specific hysteresis and this is non-specific hysteresis, and these are subtype of acute leukemia, and this is the positivity of cytokemical stains. Now there are some immunological markers for acute myeloid leukemia and acute lymphoblastic leukemia. So these are marker AML, precursor B and precursor T cell. So 13, 33 and 117, these are the markers of myeloid series. Glycoforin A is the marker of M6, while platelet antigen like CD41 is the marker of MC1. Myeloperoxidase marker is positive in M1, and we will discuss these things in acute lymphoblastic leukemia. If you have any question, you can ask your question in comments, and thank you so much.